Uganda Cancer Institute say Ugandans are not paying enough attention to a crisis that is unrolling before us, that is cancer among children. It's understood that up to 600 cases are registered every single year at the Mulago-based facility. Dr. Joyce Balagade Kambogo, a pediatric oncologist, says 75% of cases of cancer among children are either under or misdiagnosed, and that is leading to unnecessary death.
2-year-old Suleiman Mbusa is currently fighting for his life at the Uganda Cancer Institute Children's Ward. He was diagnosed with leukemia, commonly known as cancer of the blood. Mbusa was a healthy baby before he started suffering from frequent fevers and headaches. Little did his father know that these were early signs of a cancer which later deformed his face. Baluku explains that even at the eye clinic, Mbusa did not get proper diagnosis of his ailment despite undergoing several chest and head CT scans. Baluku further explains that his greatest concern is the highly priced cancer medication, which he sometimes cannot afford. He is currently looking after the child single-handedly after the mother flew out of the country for work, yet he has other children to look after. Dr. Joyce Balagade Kambogo, a pediatric oncologist, discloses that out of over 1,000 cancer patients they receive every year at the Uganda Cancer Institute, 600 are children. The commonest cancers among these children are leukemia, lymphoma, and kidney cancer.
18, we have about 600 new children that walk through the doors or the gates of Cancer Institute every year. And about 100 of these are adolescents between 15 and 18 years. The most common cancers we see in our children include cancer of the blood, that is called leukemia, cancer of the lymph nodes, that is called lymphoma from the lymphatic system, cancer of the kidney, which is called Wilms tumor, and then cancer of the muscle. So by far, those are the most common cancers that we see.
Dr. Balagade, however, cites no or wrong diagnosis and poor attitudes among factors that greatly contribute to child cancer mortality.
What are some of the reasons that these children are not surviving? No diagnosis. By no diagnosis, I mean these children remain in their homes and nobody ever thinks that they have cancer. So witchcraft is one of the very common ones. They are treated as TB, resistant malaria, and other diseases, and never ever get to go to the hospitals. Even when they get to the hospitals, they are misdiagnosed, as I have said. Sometimes it's brucella, sometimes it's typhoid, sometimes it's tuberculosis. So we have a huge challenge to make sure that our health system, our health workers, think about cancer, and those are some of the strategies that we are currently pursuing as government.
Children can easily be cured of cancer. Dr. Balagade attributes the good survival rate to improvement in equipment for treating children and specialists that have been recruited and well trained.
If you look at a global perspective, 8 out of 10 children are expected to survive their cancer and grow, go back to school, and become productive citizens of the world. However, in low and middle income countries, which is much of Africa, this number is only 3 out of 10, for many reasons which I will talk about. In Uganda, we haven't put all these children in one box to describe in general how many of our children with cancer are surviving. However, for the most common cancers, we have picked them out and looked at their survival 5 years down the road.
However, she appeals to parents and caretakers to look out for swelling in body parts, persistent fevers, difficulties to start walking, weight loss, bleeding easily, or losing teeth, as these could be symptoms of cancer in children.
That are not resolving, unexplained weight loss, unexplained fever that is not going. You've treated for malaria, you've treated for resistant malaria, typhoid. Fever is one of the most common presentations of cancer. So if you have fever that is not resolving, please have your child looked at.
And like in adults, cancer in children is not preventable.
It's about the matter of screening, the matter of early diagnosis, and so forth. All those things, except early diagnosis, do not in general apply to children, because cancer in children is not preventable. And so when we come here to speak specifically about childhood cancer, I want you to reorient yourself and think about this special population of children. In the world, they constitute about 1% of the population of people that have cancer, but in Uganda, we constitute almost about 10%.
Story by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.